evening at 7, Bruce Forsyth meets the King.
If Elvis was alive, he'd look like me now.
Liz looks back down Coronation Street.
Your husband's still there.
At 8, a question of judgment in A Touch of Frost.
It wasn't just foolish, was it, Jackie? It was fatal.
Then at 10...
Me and Jen have just laid down a new track, man.
A great Sunday evening at home with Yorkshire.
Find love on the phone. Call friends heart to heart. 0891 59 59 59.
Fast food and good for you. Eggs. Look out for the lion on the box. He stands for quality.
As a top hairdresser, I'm expected to work miracles. As a woman who understands hair, I say to my client, you can help by using organics. It contains glucosyl, which nourishes the roots. That way I get superb hair to work with, and you get what you come in for.
Our baby magazine chose Persil non-bio powder for gentleness on baby skin, fragrance, value and cleaning performance to win its best buy award.
Barclays Editions, the new current account that gives you more. Free phone 0800 00 1011.
What drove this couple to murder? How did this man evade capture for 5 years? Why did this student kill an innocent girl? For the answers, read Murder in Mind, out now.
Why Independence Day on video?
They're back in a must-see comedy.
Not again!
Deliciously entertaining.
He likes animals.
Oh, he doesn't dislike them!
Splendidly silly.
Stop that or everything under control!
And ferociously funny. Ah! So if you liked A Fish Called Wanda, you'll love Fierce Creatures.
We all know wedding costs can mount up. Simply get married in a petrol station and they'll capture the big day for you on their security cameras, free of charge. Just one more money-saving tip from McDonald's, where you can now get a McTriple with cheese for only £1.39.
Dear Volkswagen, I have recently purchased a Golf GTI. It costs less than £14,500 all in. As I appear to be the only person in the close to own one, everyone was keen to know how much it cost. So I said £16,500. Well, everyone thinks Volkswagens are expensive, don't they? Imagine my horror when I opened my newspaper to be confronted by the real price of a GTI. Do you think you could stop running adverts like this as they're ruining my image? I've done what I can to stop people finding out, and so far I think I've got away with it. Yours faithfully, James Archer.
It's usually hot August days, like really hot, like 95 degrees they come out. It just depends on the snake.
A high street electrical shop in Halifax and a couple were seen loitering near a display of electrical items. Later, a member of staff discovered a video recorder missing from the same display. This couple may be able to help police win the incident. He's in his mid-20s, 5 feet 10 inches tall, with a swarthy complexion. She has shoulder-length, curly, dirty blonde hair. Ring Crime Stoppers if you know their identity.
When Fleet Street moved to Wapping, Britain was promised a wider choice of newspapers.
But what have barons like Murdoch and Maxwell done to the industry?
When Robert Maxwell arrived at the Mirror, he turned the paper into a family album.
Editors will be free to produce their newspapers without interference.
No, I mean, that was just a lie. Maxwell just told lies all the time. It was just second nature to him.
Network First examines Breaking the Mirror, The Murdoch Effect. Tuesday at 10:40 on Yorkshire.
This is Channel 3 Yorkshire Television.
A murder inquiry is underway in Sussex after a 13-year-old girl was found battered to death at her home in Hastings. Her body was discovered last night by her foster father when he returned from taking one of his daughters to a music lesson. Sussex police say the girl had only been left alone for about half an hour. Millions of TV viewers have seen a police surveillance video of some of the men a newspaper claims were the killers of black teenager Stephen Lawrence. The footage, broadcast last night by Channel 4, showed youths brandishing knives and talking about skinning and torching black people. It now seems that none of the five named by the Daily Mail plans to sue the paper for libel. Upsets continue in the FA Cup, with Chesterfield and Wrexham of the second division both winning through to the quarter-finals. Mark Crossley, the Forest goalkeeper, conceded a penalty. He was sent off for his foul. Tom Curtis scored the spot kick that knocked out the Premiership side to take Chesterfield into the last eight for the first time in their history. Wrexham will join them after they came from behind to beat Birmingham 3-1 at St Andrews. That's it. We have more bulletins throughout the night and the morning news at 5:30.
Not debate.
Beatles wrote the book, Oasis stole a copy from the library.
This is debate.
I think you're just talking absolute trivial crap.
Ooh, meow.
You sound like the worst of the papers. Go away and shut up.
This is karaoke.
After this, your ears and your life may never be the same again. Stand and deliver Wednesdays and Fridays late on Yorkshire.
This is Channel 3 Yorkshire Television.